guys. Thank you for coming.
This is Ezra. We are your MCs for tonight. We are so excited to be here.
Yeah, this is Caleb, by the way.
I already said that. But no, we are seriously so excited to be your guys' MCs tonight.
Seriously.
It's gonna be an awesome night. We're so hyped to take you back to the 90s.
The best
about
era.
The 90s.
The best era in the world, am I right?
Now, the 90s was a world full of boomboxes.
CD players.
Stayed by the bell.
Gigapets.
That's right.
Bowl cuts, baby, bowl cuts.
Frosted tips, baby.
Little Fresh Prince.
We got comfy couches.
We got Super Nintendos to go on the comfy couches.
Big wheels.
And of course, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
We got Michael Jordan. MC Hammer.
No, I'm a master. I'm a master of the 90s. Rugrats.
I got Rugrats
on the shirt.
We got Fresh Prince again, round two.
Rollerblading, of course.
And Husker football on my right.
And the big part of the 90s were us as babies.
That's
so
true. That's
we're
true.
Pretty much, we know everything about the 90s, you know. We grew up in the 90s.
Yeah, we pretty much owned the 90s,
yeah,
honestly.
I mean, really, I peaked in the 90s.
The 90s, like, that is, you know, if there was one decade that described us, it's the 90s.
Right.
We've got some contestants here, maybe like 97 babies, 98. They don't really know anything about the 90s, okay?
95, baby!
Yeah,
95!
The 90s was our decade.
That I mean, we know the 90s, am I right?
No. So we've got 21 contestants today, and their goal is to come back to the 90s. Their goal is to join us in the decade of primetime.
The best decade in the world. Their name will go in the history books in the 90s. The best decade in the world.
So they're trying to get back to the 90s. We've got a huge prize for the winner. And
big prize. You guys are gonna wanna stay till the end.
Yeah, so whoever wins this competition, best talent, best catwalk, all together, whatever the judges put together, they're joining us in the 90s. So
big finale.
Yeah.
So first up,
we gotta introduce the contestants.
You guys wanna see who's in the show? Where's the oh, 1 second.
Representing Junkyard, we have Lyndon Mitchell.
Escorted by Shay Kellerman. For the Lodge, we have Josh Subcheck. Escorted by Nicole Handman.
Representing Treeport, we have Harley Coon. Chandler, escorted by Chandler Collins.
Representing the Sandlot, we have Mitch Jones.
For the bakery, we have Jack Weekly.
For the dark, we have Macy Casson. And escorted by Ashley Green.
Representing the Grove, we have Chase Worth. Escorted by Claire Anderson.
Representing Cockpit, we have Ethan Lucero, escorted by Molly Garden.
For the Neverland, we have Meslo Sandoval, escorted by Kaylee Cooper.
Representing the Shire, we have Ethan King, escorted by Emma Bollinger.
For the Boondocks, we have Dustin Stomper, escorted by Megan Newman.
For Atlas, we have Hunter Baxter, escorted by Callie Lewis.
For the Summit, we have Quinn Raskey, escorted by
For Garden, we have Reese Simpson, escorted by Anna Luzinski.
And for the Galaxy, we have John Vargas, escorted by Marisa Shonemar.
Representing the Woods, Dodie Kim, escorted by Hannah Lang.
And for the Reef, we have Sawyer Olson, escorted by Haley Javis.
Representing La Mesa, we have Sheldon Long, escorted by Kaylin Mizell.
And for the Abbey, we have Kay Collins, escorted by Leza.
And representing Boardwalk, we have Isaac Gaspar, escorted by Bailey DeHaley.
Of a town called Bel Air.
Thank you.
too good to us, wasn't it, Ezra?
Yeah, there you have it.
You know, so cozy in the turtleneck.
The 90s was an age of great clothing and really great memories.
True.
You know, it's not really a childhood memory for me. Like I said, I peaked in the 90s.
Amen.
But, you know, really a popular thing to me, what made the 90s was, you know, I pooped and peed myself a lot.
Oh, that's true. That was classic. I was doing the same thing.
It's a very classic thing to do in the 90s.
You know, I have a story about, you know, just like classic things in the 90s.
Let's hear it.
My family, yeah. It's just, so like one time, my little brother David, right, he was, you know, going to the bathroom, and what happens, he uses the toilet paper and decided to just throw the entire roll in the toilet.
Naturally.
Clogged the toilet. And so what happened was the toilet started to flood the whole house. And so like classic 90s, I threw on a swimsuit and just started sloshing around the house. It's just classic 90s.
That's the idea, yeah.
We're trying to help these contestants get back to the 90s, you know.
Yeah. You just saw everyone who's competing, you know, we really have to nail what classic 90s was. One thing my brother liked to do to me was, you know, mislead me a lot. I wanted to make dinner for my family.
Classic
macaroni and cheese. Big thing in the 90s. Yeah. So big thing for college students, super cheap. Amen? And, favorite thing, SpongeBob, also 90s. You put these two worlds together, what do you get? Macaroni SpongeBob.
Come on. Idea for all
that stuff was fly. I'm telling you, fly. That was all that in a bag of chips. And so I wanted to make, you know, mac and cheese, SpongeBob edition for my family. So now I'm cooking the noodles, getting it all ready.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't quite read the instructions well enough.
That's classic.
Classic 90s. So I'm putting, you know, the butter and the cheeses in and mixing it all together. And I go to serve this macaroni. And one thing I forgot to do was drain the water. So it was just this soup with, there's Patrick floating up, and there's SpongeBob up on the top. And that was one thing, and my brother, who's 4 years older than me, also a 90s kid, didn't tell me that. So dinner was also, you know, classic 90s, you made soup instead of macaroni.
Yeah, I mean, that was total 90s. I remember football was big in the 90s for me, you know, and that was back in the day, I was playing ball. You know, I didn't have a team I was really on or anything, or a ball. I would just kind of run across the living room and throw it up and kind of imagine everyone around me, right. But everyone was doing that.
Right.
It's just kind of how football used to be.
That was the essence of the 90s, you know? And kind of back to the poop and pee thing, crazy stuff. 90s was a crazy time. It was a party. It was wild. And so one time, back in the 90s, right, my mom wanted to make this garden. So she got this massive amount of dirt put into our driveway. And so naturally, classic 90s, me and my brother go to play in this dirt.
In the dirt.
Of course.
Everyone's playing dirt.
And you know, one thing leads to another. He ends up burying me. So, and eventually I'm like, oh, it's been, you know, 30 minutes maybe, we're just playing in the dirt. And I'm like, Josiah, I need to get out, I need to go pee really bad. Like, dude, let me out of here. And he's like, oh, I buried you, you can't get out. And I was like, no, let me out, I need to go to the bathroom. And he didn't let me out, and so I was like, fine, I'll just do it here. And so I'm buried, so you can't see anything. So I just, like, I peed myself, which was a classic 90 things to do.
It's not socially acceptable.
This was the era, okay? And he didn't believe me. I was like, okay, I just went. And he's like, no, you did, no, you didn't. So he stuck his hand into the dirt. He's like, you didn't pee yourself. And he stuck his hand, just comes out as mud. Classic 90s, right?
Why did we put that on the slide? That was perfect. Oh, man. Yeah, the 90s was a good time, and we have definitely more to tell you.
That's
guys.
What our contestants wants to be a part of, is that era. Right?
We're trying to bring it back to the real 90s, the way we know it, of course. So, so enjoy their catwalks. It's going to be a pretty amazing time. We've got some hilarious...
We've got some great stuff coming up for you guys. You saw the dance, you saw everybody coming up. Get pumped, get excited. We've got some great acts, and right now, you're about to see their catwalks. Doing a little introduction for you.
Let's bounce.
Thank you, guys. We're out here.
So I got the wrong. lucky I had to do that. I keep a flag hanging on the back side, but only on the left side. Yeah, that's the side.
Thank you.
All right, you don't have much time here. We're gonna have to keep you going.
Legend, you're eating something cool.
Messing around, acting crazy, not about
no
food.
Points
Sorry.
There. All right, number nine. Quick.
What? Not. Literally an entire sentence in the word. So I'm thinking,
All right, we're gonna have to just keep going here.
You carry that, but same for the negative of a preceding group of words. Episode one, the Phantom Menace was a great.
Not. All right, keep it going. He's got 4 points and.
So cool.
Oh,
so cool. Nice work.
See, we got
nice work.
Cool.
A round
awesome.
Of applause.
Yeah. Nice work.
Macy is our winner. And give it up for Lyndon in the first act.
Hello, guys. Give us 1 second. We gotta tune a little bit.
Yeah, Lyndon.
We are banned. We're gonna play music. Seriously, just play the Jeopardy song. Okay, but seriously, let's play some music. This is Say It Ain't So by Weezer. I never could.
We have a t-shirt here for one Mason. Come on up and receive your t-shirt. Just so you know, there might be some more giving out of t-shirts tonight, so sit at the edge of your seat.
Stay posted.
Up next, with an awesome performance, we've got Abe.
Let's bounce.
Baby food too, a lot of gobbling up like this. He's doing some of these motions. It's kind of how, you know,
I needed help a lot of times getting it into my mouth, but it's just a 90s thing. Oh
yeah, I mean, that makes sense. We've got a pretty sweet act coming up here. It's Josh Subcheck, and it is the Bottle Flip.
Oh,
sing.
Ladies and gentlemen, I wrote this song for a very special person. And I know you have no idea who I am. But I just want you to know I love you. And here we go. Wait, 1 second. It's called Dish Has Got a Hold on Me. I took a little journey to the unknown. I come back changed, I can feel it in my bones. I told with forces that my eyes can't see. Now Dish has got a hold on me. Oh, Dish has got a hold on me. How long, baby, have we been in love? Feels like ages. Oh, you say you don't know me. There ain't language for the things I feel. The whole day she's got a hold on me. The whole day she's got a hold on me. Love a red hair like fire. Burning in my soul's eye. Yet the goddess of the wind. Though I'll never be your boyfriend. Follow me into the endless night. I can bring your dreams to life. The whole day she's got a hold on me. The whole day she's got a hold on me.
New relationship on campus, I guess. It's begun. Well, I'm sure he hopes. Something that I never did in the 90s. Anyway, next up is going to be Mitch.
For the Sandlot.
Dad, because he wants Broncos tickets, and also for my sister, because she told me she'd kill me if I didn't get Broncos tickets.
Yeah.
Hi, Kyla. I see train of green. Red roses too, I watch them bloom for me and you. I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. I was near. Dark blessed night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of a rainbow are so pretty in the sky. They're also on the faces of people walking by. I
see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? Verily saying, I love you. I see children cry, and I watch them grow. They learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
You know, it reminded me a lot of the colors that you see in the 90s.
No, that's true.
You got your red, green, blue.
It's a great era.
Yellow, like we said. All on your shirt as well.
You know, the theme of this, you're trying to get back to this era, as we've made quite clear. And here we've got all these colors. Isn't it just something you want to get into?
For sure. I want to get into the 90s.
They don't. But the contestants do, I assure you. And like I said, there's going to be a big, big prize at the end.
Caleb, I just thought, is what if at the end of the show we gave the winner a bowl cut? I mean, they might be in. No, they're not going to be in it.
Well, we'll see.
Are you guys into that? I mean,
okay, let's give the winner a bowl cut.
There'll be a different big prize, but it's an idea.
All right, next up is Jack.
Here we go for the bakery. Hey, guys. Kind of nervous. Thought I'd open with a joke. That's okay. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Interrupting cow.
Interrupting cow.
No, just kidding. But hey, you might be thinking to yourself, why is this guy wearing a dinosaur costume? Again, it's a little overused. But it's because I'm going to be making minute rice in 30 seconds. So the name of the game is Insulation. So get yourself two styrofoam cups, some really, really hot water. A little more hot water in this one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Get yourself some minute rice, right?
Yes!
How are you all doing tonight? I'm sorry. I don't care, I'm sorry. If I could have a male volunteer. Hands, hands, let's see him. Hands? Yes, you, sir. All right, so would you please share your name with the audience?
It's Richard.
It's Richard. That's okay, give it up for Richard. While this is cooking, Richard, would you please take a seat? Richard, what is your favorite color? Speak into the microphone.
It's purple.
Purple? Why is that?
Because I like it.
Very nice, very nice. All right, well, this is just about done cooking, so you're gonna need two bowls. I should have a cooking show. In this strainer. But while I'm doing this, what do you call fake spaghetti? An impasta. I know. Save the applause for after the show. Alright, now that your rice is done cooking, I'm just gonna plop it in this bowl. Can I get another volunteer, preferably a young lady? Hands, hands. Yes? Yes, you, over there. Yeah. Alright, please. Share your name with the audience. I'm sorry, one more time.
Hannah. Hannah. Hannah, grab a seat. No, your seat. Go. Hannah, come back. I'm just kidding. Sit down, please. All right, Hannah. What are you interested in?
Cats.
Cats? Our friend over here likes cats, too. Oh, you know what this means? Please, tell her what you're interested in.
What?
Tell her what you're interested in.
I like cats.
Say cats again.
Cats. You're welcome.
The next part of the trick is Jonathan eating minute rice in 30 seconds. I'm not kidding. Use your hands. Use your hands. Give it up for our volunteers. All right, I have a prize for you guys. Just stay put. I'll be right back.
Looks like somebody's on a date.
Well, that was cold. Put on some jackets for that one. Thanks. That was a great act right there. And next up, we have
Macy.
Macy, of course.
Ha ha ha!
drums.
But you guys will have to decide which Donald impersonation you like more. Next up, we have Chase.
Welcome, CCU. I'm gonna be your next King Cougar, okay? It's fantastic to be here. First, I'd like to thank all my opponents for being complete losers. You see, I'm different than Bill Clinton. I'm not George W. Bush. We need to win in volleyball. I'm not, Obama. I'm Donald Trump, okay? CCU great again. We're gonna build a wall around Getter, okay? We're gonna make freshman row pay for it. Oh, this wall. It's gonna be a huge, beautiful wall. It's gonna be fantastic. Loves me. You know, I have people come up to and say to me, fix tuition. We're gonna lower tuition. I know Jim McCormick. And we're going to do it. You know it, I know it, everyone knows it. Everyone tells me my biggest problem is parking spots. We're gonna make CCU parking great again, people. Our students are going to China. China. We gotta bring him back from study abroad. They say my hands are too small. I say I've got the best hands for the job, baby. School of Mines is sending us students with low GPA. I'm gonna kick the crap out of Mines. They are our biggest issue. You know it, I know it, everyone knows it. And I wanna see the other candidates' emails. I'm looking at you, Mary. Where are they? Look at my body! I'm the most physically fit to be King Cougar. Obviously. And if I'm not voted, just know it's all rigged against me. So vote for me. And if you don't, you're wrong.
That was a great performance. Great performance. Seems like he thought he was all that in a bag of chips, though, so I don't know.
Next up, we have Ethan Lucero.
Oh.
awesome. But I found myself kind of drifting into sleep, I think, because in the 90s, I always fell asleep to puppet shows.
That's true, that's classic.
I guess I was a little young. Maybe.
Next up, we have Mel.
Hi, what's up, y'all? My name's Mel. I'm doing a little song that I wrote, actually a cover of Tupac. Can I hear it from my Tupac fans? Yeah, yeah. Okay. And then I got Megan right here on the vocals. So let me know what you guys think. All right, let's get it started. Sin has me living on the dark side, caught up in a whirlwind, where can my soul reside? And even if I change, who's to blame? My savior, who gave me fame through his name, praise my savior, yeah. What could I do? Christ, who give me life through the hard times and through the strife. The Lord sincerely says, run to me when you need me. I'll never leave, you just need to truly believe in me. As you can see, His word is eternal and true. What could I do? Jesus Christ helps me get through. I pray, Lord, renew me and my livelihood. Cause to be understood is to take on sainthood. Yeah, my king, he died for me. His reign can never stop. Bringing the increase to the peace by the only rock who never stops. When I ask Jehovah, will he ever change? He tells me no. Eternally, he'll always be the same.
Take these broken wings. I need your hands to come and heal me once again.
Until the end of time.
Until the end of time.
Please Lord, forgive me for my life of sin. Take this heart, renew me and make me whole again. So you know, I'm thankful you went to the cross. You, O Lord, have searched me and know my thoughts. Father, vindicate me and clear my shame. Bear my sin, I count everything as lost in Jesus' name. You predestined me to live this life. According to your will, I fight. Watching the whole world move by your might. When quiet times disappear, listen to his word. Love the Lord, praise his name. That cuts like a sword. Who cannot trust in this cold world? The prince of the year has been released from the underworld. But I ain't tripping, the Lord is in control. He rose as our reassurance for our transference of sin. It was meant to happen. Besides praising, the only thing I did good was upraising. Until the end of time.
Broken wings, I need your hands to come and heal me once again.
Until the end of time.
So I can fly away until the end of time. Take these broken wings. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. That saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Until the end of time.
Nice work. That was awesome. We were worshiping Jesus in the 90s. We still are today. That's pretty awesome. Waiting for that. Psyched. Next up is Ethan in the last talent of the first act.
Let's bounce.
applause for all of the first.
Give a round of
first
applause.
First talents. Act one is done. That's our first act right there. We got some great 90s acts. Got some great competition, but now we got some free t-shirts. I have always wanted to do this. I never got paid for it. I'm going to the back. My best goal. It's harder than it looks. All right.
You know, Caleb, there's still one thing.
Runway.
Yeah, it's not good.
Lefty. There we go.
Caleb, there's still just... I can't get it out of my head.
What are you talking about?
I want to give the winner a bowl cut.
I mean, I just... We don't even have materials for that.
It's 90s, though. It's just... It's the essence of the 90s.
Talk about it amongst yourselves. We'll see if we can do it. See if we can get some clippers or something. Maybe it'll happen. Enjoy right. Intermission.
That's act one.
Sheldon on guitar.
Hey, we're back. Alright, this one's called Are You Gonna Be My Girl?
Yeah.
Are you gonna be my girl?
That's incredible. I'm honestly so pumped about having a full band on stage.
That literally rocked.
Thank you. Next up is gonna be Dustin with a little ditty you all might remember.
You're gonna love this.
Doing good? Beautiful. Hi. How's it going? Alright. If you know the song, you can sing along if you'd like. If not, it's okay. I don't care. Alright? Yeah? If you like to talk to tomatoes, if your squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes up and down the produce aisle, have we got a show for you? VeggieTales, VeggieTales, VeggieTales. VeggieTales, broccoli, celery, gotta be VeggieTales. There's never, ever, 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 ever been a show like VeggieTales. There's never, ever, ever, ever been a show like VeggieTales. It's time for VeggieTales.
Childhood, but that's not what this is about. It's about the 90s.
That's right.
Anyway, our next act is Hunter.
Hunter, yeah, that's right.
Hey guys.
Hi.
I'm gonna take something from our 90s childhood and speed it up a little bit.
Yes.
This one has a little star. Say what? A lot of fish there are. Yes, some are red and some are blue and some are old and some are new. Some are sad and sad and glad and some are very, very bad. Why are they sad and glad and bad? I don't know. Go ask your dad. Hey, hey, hey. Some are thin and some are fat. The fat one has a yellow hat. From there to here, from here to there, funny things are everywhere. Here are some who like to run. They run for fun in the hot, hot sun. Oh me, oh my, oh me, oh my. What a lot of funny things to go by. Some have 2 feet, some have four. Some have 6 feet, some have more. Where they come from, I can't say. But I bet they come from a long, long way. We see them come, we see them go. Some are faster, some are slow. Some are high and some are low. Not one of them is like another. Don't be asking why, go ask your mother. Man, look at his fingers. 1, 2, 3, how many fingers do I see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, he has 11. In the middle of the ocean, got my fishies. And we squatting up and looking spiffy. Yeah, we rolling in a pack of 50. Juking out those sharks and being shifty. Some might call us just a little sporty. But we just be calling this one shorty. Yeah, the waves are getting kind of stormy. So we gotta leave here very shortly. One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, 11, this is something new. I wish I had 11 too. Bump, 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 bump. Did you ever ride a wump? We have a wump with just one hump. Here's a guy called Mr. Gump. Mr. Gump has a sound on him up. If you'd like to get the bump, 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 just jump on the hump of a wump of gum. Who am I? My name is Ned. I do not like my little bed. This is no good. This is not right. My feet stick out of bed all night. And when I pull them in, oh dear, my head sticks out of bed up here. We like a mic and it's made for three. Our mic sits back and back, you see. We like a mic and this is why. Mic doesn't work when the hills get high. Hey there, Ned. How do you do? Tell me, what is new? How are things in the little bed? What is new? Please tell me, Ned. I do not like this bed at all. A lot of things have come to call a cow, a dog, a cat, a mouse. Oh what? A bed? Oh what? A house! Oh dear, I can not hear. Will you please come over near? Will you please look in my ear? There must be something there, I fear. Say look, a bird was in my ear. In the middle of the ocean got my fishies. And we squatting up and looking spiffy. Yeah, we rolling in a pack of 50. Juking out the sharks and being shifty. Some might call us just a little sporty. But we just be calling this one shorty. Yeah, the waves are getting kind of stormy. So we gotta leave here very shortly. One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey.
One of my dreams in the 90s was to be a rapper.
Sure, wasn't ours.
He's living my dream right now. That was awesome. Well done. Good job.
All right, next up is going to be Quinn.
My name is Quinn. I haven't really been doing magic for too long, but I got some nifty stuff in here. First, I have this paper. And then I have this pen. And separate is nothing, but put them together and you have something else. So before I start this trick, does anybody in the audience have $1 that they'd be willing to donate for this trick? One person. Oh, here we go. Perfect. That would work too, but dollar happens. Next, is there any single female in the audience right now? Okay, for my first trick, I'll give you a dollar if you write your number on this paper. All right, for my second trick, 970-555-0338. You're welcome, boys. All right, now, is there anybody with a water bottle in the audience that they would let me see for a little bit? Oh, this will work. Will you put it in my bag? Perfect. Does anybody have a hat that I could borrow? Anybody? Oh, the judges are on fire. All right, last but not least, does anybody have a pair of sandals or shoes I could see? Judges again, perfect. Perfect. All right, judges, you saw everything go into my bag. Did it come out at any point? Perfect. Now what I'm about to do is gonna blow your minds. But before I do it, have to go get my crazy prop.
Well, that was magical. It was incredible.
My mind was blown.
Seriously.
What? You know, actually, he was rocking the 90s style.
A little bit.
Oh, there. I mean, did you see his hair? It was, no offense, like, it was almost a bowl cut, though.
He's, like, kind of begging for it, honestly. I don't know.
It's kind of like he wants one, but
I don't know. Yeah, anyway, our next act is going to be Reese. Yeah!
Check those memes to see what people gotta say, cause they won't say that stuff out loud anyway. Then I take my mental up and head back to the camp, where I get some food smothered in God's wrath.
it's not working, just like it. Nah, I don't know, I'm just joking. Then I gotta deal with all these nighttime restrictions. Feels to me like some unfair affliction. Snap, time is nearing 10:01. I gotta grab my bag and I gotta run. But when you think about it, this school ain't that bad. There's a lot of great things, no need to get mad. So stop complaining and enjoy the fact that you're here. Cause guess what? Your debt is rising every year.
Living our 90s dreams right there. That's pretty awesome.
It really means that I just did not make it.
Next up, we've got Dodie. That's how we teach you the 90s way to do it. Anyway, Sawyer's up next.
I'll be there someday.
If I can be strong, I know every mile will be worth my while. I would go most anywhere to feel like I belong.
There's something your mother and I have been meaning to tell you.
So sweet. Something I can never do. Now, I'm still stuck on the bowl cut.
Here you go again. Talking about the bowl cut.
But I mean, even if the winner, whoever the winner is, like, not everyone could get a bowl cut.
That's true.
Someone has to get a bowl cut.
I'm not getting a bowl cut. You're not getting a bowl cut.
Get a bowl cut.
Sawyer's getting a bowl cut. How about
He's got the hair for it, right?
I don't know. He's got the hair for it.
The winner could get, you know, there's a big prize.
There's also Cade. Who's up next? And he's got long hair as well.
Here we go. Who knows?
Hi, guys. So, tonight I'm going to be spilling my heart out to you guys a little bit. I've got a bit of spoken word. It's about the grind of English class and a little bit of proofreading, too. And, by the way, has anyone seen... Has anyone seen Emperor's New Groove?
Yeah.
Sweet. Okay. Where's some? Alright, I call this the importance of proofreading. What the? Has this ever happened to you? You work very hard on a English paper for Clash. Then you get a very glow raid, like a D or a D equals. And all because you're the liverwurst spoiler. Proofreading your peppers is a matter of the utmost impotence. This is a problem that affects manly students. I myself was such a bed spoiler once upon a term that my English teacher in sophomoric year, Miss Smith, said I would never go to a good collage. And that's all I really wanted, was to go to a good collage. Not just ANSI Community College collage. I really need to be challenged dentally. I know this makes me sound like Ennard, but I really wanted to go to an ivory legal collage. So I needed to improvement. Or gone would be my dream of going to Harvard or jail or prison, you know, prison in New Jersey. So I got myself a spell checker. And I figured I was on Sleazy Street. But there are several missed aches that a spell chucker can't catch. For instance, if you accidentally leave a word, your spell checker won't put it in. Alto, your spell check off might replace a word with one you had absolutely no intention of using. Because it don't dude what you want it to dude. It only dude what you tell it to dude. You're the one with the hand on the mouth going clish, clish, clish. It just goes to show you how embargo one careless clish of the mouth can be. Which reminds me of one time in my junior mint. The teacher read my entire paper on a sale of two kitties out loud to all my flaskmates. I'm not joking. I'm totally serial. It was the most humidifying experience of my entire life. Being laughed at pubically. So do yourself a favor and follow these two pieces of advice. One, there's no prosecution for careful editing. And three, when it comes to proofreading, the red penny's your favorite. Friend, it's your friend. Thank you.
Nice job, Cade. Spelling, that was awesome.
That was so sweet.
For me in the 90s, spelling was quite the challenge. I could hardly even speak.
Yeah, same. I figured it out, though.
Cool. Hey, next up, we've got Isaac.
Heck yeah.
And desperation at the Cincinnati Zoo. A four-year-old boy slips into the zoo's gorilla habitat and over a moat wall.
One last thing, they're gonna do the dance for you guys one more time. Here we go. Bring them back out.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute and just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
touch this. Can't touch this.
Like it's already tallied up here. What do we got?
Okay.
Interesting, they already tallied it up while we were, I don't know. What does it say?
Caleb, did you enter this competition?
No.
Your name's on this card.
I do like the 90s a lot.
Someone's gotta get a bowl cut.
It is 90s,
yeah.
Time.
see it in your head. A lot of people don't use a bowl, but it really helps me envision just what I'm getting at. This is a bowl cut, my friend. Not a mullet. Actually, when I was a kid, I always had bowl cuts, and that's not a lie. I always wanted the bowl cut because when I thought of bowl, I thought of the animal. So I thought that I was like getting this cool haircut that made me look like a bowl. And I just never connected the dots that this was actually using a bowl on my head. Feel much better now. How do you feel, Caleb?
Oh my gosh, I honestly have no idea what I just did to myself. Oh, we have them. We have the top five.
I'll just trim it up.
You gotta touch it up.
Yeah.
Don't sweat it being straight, man. All right. We got our top five here. Can we get a drum roll, please? Number one, we've got. This is not in any sort of order besides five. Macy. We've also got Ethan Lucero. Oh, yeah. And we've got John Vargas. We've got Isaac Gaspar. And last but not least, Dodie Kim.
So we've got some questions for these guys. You've made it to the top five, okay? How do you feel? Just an action.
Give us an action for how you feel. There you go.
Okay, that's awesome. A little nervous, a little on edge here.
All right, I got a question for all you guys, all right? I wanna know what your favorite part about the 90s is. We're just gonna go down the line here.
What's my ideal first date? Thank you for asking. Me and the woman of my dreams sitting on the beach enjoying a well-cooked burrito. And as we finish, we throw our tinfoil into the nearest trash receptacle. And we then partake in a perfect swan dive off a 250-foot cliff into the ocean. As we arise and arrive on the beach, I look into her eyes and she looks into mine and I say to her, "You are beautiful," and she says, "I know."
favorite part of the 90s? That's a good question. You know, thinking back to the 90s, you know, being in diapers and just running around shirtless, I think my favorite part would be, you know, being conceived. I'm glad to be born, so I think that's probably mine. Just, you know, entering this world with a good start.
Well, that's my favorite part too, but one thing I love about the 90s was there was someone that was born in 97. He was the first, possibly the first, Hispanic King Cougar of CCU. But the denim's good too, yeah, that's good.
Wow, I love the 90s. Yeah, so many things. But what I also love is my grandma, who is here tonight. Thank you for coming, Grandma Mary. Love you. I also like Justin Timberlake. Thank you.
Alright, I'm gonna be straight up honest. I don't think I can top any of that. So I'm gonna just gonna say probably the style or the TV shows.
Nice, right on. Thanks, guys. Next question. If you, so you're walking back from class, right? You walk into your dorm and there's an alligator in your living room. What do you do and what object do you use?
I'll do not need an object. I'll destroy.
Alright, I have a question here for, let's see, I want to ask it to John. John, tell me about, just describe the King Cougar experience for me, just like a couple highlights, just the whole King Cougar experience.
Well, I feel like I'm going to vomit, but it's all good. Oh my god, there's so much practice, there's a lot of work, but I mean, there's so many people cheering for you, and it's just like, and oh my god, I'm just like everywhere right now, but yeah. Watching that bowl cut happen was freaking awesome. I mean, that doesn't happen. So there's my answer.
All right, guys, you got another question?
Can you just, Isaac, now you had a really deep act. Can you just explain to me what inspired you to do this?
Injustice for gorillas.
Love you, Grandma. All right, Dodie, if you could be any character from your favorite TV show, who would it be?
First person that came to mind was Jackie Chan.
I don't know what TV... What TV show is Jackie Chan on?
Cartoons?
All right, we'll take that.
Okay, last and final question for our guy here. If you could be any article of clothing, what would you be and why?
This comes from my soul, so I have a passion for wool socks. They keep your feet nice and cozy during the winter, but yet they aerate it during the summer. And I don't know, if King Cougars could wear wool socks, that'd be awesome.
That was truly beautiful, thank you. Our top five, ladies and gentlemen.
We have one more surprise before we let you know everything. Underneath your seats, if you see a colored, I think it's a CD or something like that, you can get a free t-shirt after the show. So check out under your seats, and then come see us after the show. And you will get a free t-shirt like this one, Rugrats style, 90s. That'll be sweet.
So Caleb, do we have the winner?
I think we do not yet, we are seeing. So, we're gonna have to ask you a couple more questions. Wait, okay, let's ask them who they think is gonna win.
Ooh. Just think of a name.
Who do I think is gonna win? I saw this.
You can't answer yourself.
I saw this rabbit outside a little bit before I came, and he was really cute, and I think he should win.
Do we have any time to like get the rabbit back, like so we can tally his votes in? Okay, no, we don't have that time. Sorry, the rabbit can't win. Dang it! I wanted the rabbit too. Cody.
Honestly, I think Ethan. I got Ethan.
Oh. Let's hear from our audience. What does the audience think? We'll just kind of go like this, huh? Come on, Ethan. Come on, for John. That was pretty neck and neck. Jody. I don't know. It's pretty neck and neck here. Judges are still tallying up their votes. Should Ezra get a bowl cut now since we got time? I just want to cut everybody's hair.
I think one is enough, good sir.
Fair enough. All right, we have the official sheet here deal.
The time.
Okay, Miss Kelsey Ebert. Everyone give a round of applause to Kelsey Ebert. Come here.
I actually put a lot of work in this show, but she... Not possible without Kelsey, thank you.
Oh. Oh, these are the prizes. Okay, here we go. This is the prize.
Four.
Okay, give us a drum roll. This is third place. In third place, we have Isaac.
Come on up here, Isaac. We got a prize for you.
Open that up. Tell us what it is. It's not a bowl cut.
Got some hockey tickets.
Oh, you got some hockey tickets. Yeah, Colorado Avalanche.
That is seriously fun. That's fun stuff. All right. Next up, second place. Give me a drum roll.
Open it up.
What do you see?
I see more tickets for the Houston Rockets versus Denver Nuggets.
Oh, heck yeah, basketball! Nice! All right, what could the first place prize be? And who is it?
Who's gonna make it to the 90s?
Drum roll, please.
Who will make it?
All righty. Your winner of the 2016 King Cougar is Macy! His prize is Denver Broncos tickets! Go and see the world champ in action! Great job, Macy. Any comments for the crowd? Any thanks?
Thanks.
All right, give him one more round of applause. Thank you to UPC for setting all this up. Thank you to everyone who helped out with it, all the backstage crew that you didn't see, well, sometimes you saw. Thanks for coming, guys. We hope you had an awesome night. Great job, everybody.
So what was the inspiration behind your act?
I just got really emotional on that day when a poor gorilla's life was taken without any just cause. That is all I have to say about that.
Going into the competition, do you have any idea whatsoever that you could win?
No, not really. It just kind of happened. Nice.
Who was in the gorilla suit?
Okay, I will reveal this to you guys. This is live here on CCU television. James Franco, aka Harrison Sagamore, aka my roommate Harry, was in that gorilla suit. And he danced his heart out.
Very good.
Two balls.
Very good. And then what was your favorite part of the whole experience?
Winning tickets. That was very enjoyable. I enjoyed it a lot.
Good. And is there anything you want to add?
Let's go Cougs.
Tell us, what was the thought process behind your act?
It would have to be, last minute rushing.
definitely provides a lot of inspiration. I definitely drew my inspiration from a mime. If he could speak, he would have spoke great words, but his name was Tapeface. And I also drew it from waking up in the morning late to class. You know, you just gotta throw on some clothes and just go rushing. So definitely some of that.
And didn't you have any idea whatsoever that you could win?
Honest, I had no idea. I walked up there and I'm surprised they called my name. I thought I was stupid. I thought I was like just gonna be kicked off in the back, but it turned out the judges liked it. My favorite part of this whole experience would probably have to be being in a room full of 21 guys who are just characters. They literally like take forever to get control of. It's like being in a room with 21 kindergartners and just trying to be controlling them. And it was just a great experience. I want to add Jared Cummings has a nice face. Definitely that.
What inspired your catwalk, and then what inspired your act?
All of my ideas that I come up with, every good idea I have, I come up with during my morning shower. I wake up, I get in the shower, and things just come to me. And that's when it happens, that's when the magic happens, and that's when I figure out my life, and that's where all this came from.
Perfect. When you had all the winners back for your catwalk, did you actually think you had a shot at winning?
I was confident because I knew some of my stuff was kind of funny, but I wasn't for sure or anything, but it was really exciting to have that actually happen, so that was really cool.
And the duck voice, how do you do that?
The duck voice, a lot of people ask me if my voice hurts afterwards, and it doesn't, because I don't do it with my throat, I do it in my cheek, so.
It's out right here. It's out right here.
So it doesn't hurt at all, and I've been able to do it since I was about like 7 years old, and I've just perfected it over the years, and it's one of my assets now.
What was your favorite part of this whole experience?
I think my favorite part was being able to put the message out there of my ideal first date, because you know I'm really looking for that God-fearing woman, and just to kind of get that message out there so that if anybody's you know looking for something on the other side of that they kind of know that I'm serious about that. And that
what went in to planning this whole thing?
Yeah, so they came and asked us, you know, can you guys host King Cougar because of what we did with O'Malley's Alley, and we were like, heck yeah, like we'd love to, of course, having no idea what we would do, but we just threw ourselves at it and like, yeah, we'll host it, we'll get to it, we'll come up with something, definitely. And then, you know, going through ideas, what are some ideas we came up with?
We honestly had nothing. They came up with 90s and we were just like, that sounds good, I mean, whatever, yeah, let's go with it. But then we started like digging into the 90s and realized like we actually like sort of already dressed kind of 90s at times and like kind of loved the 90s without knowing it, and then we started talking about how we grew up in the 90s. It was a fun time.
We also realized how little we knew about the 90s. We thought like, oh yeah, we'll just come up with some funny things from our childhood, but we just didn't really have anything. So yeah, then it just spurred into that, and then we were like, okay, we're doing 90s, but we can't like have ridiculous accents like in O'Malley's with the Frenchmen. So we were like, how can we top what we did in O'Malley's of just being total goofballs? And Caleb was like, hey, I can get a bowl cut. Like, that's the banger. We have to do that. That is the pinnacle of us hosting. So
the bowl cut, it was something that you talked about the entire time. Ezra kept alluding to it. He obviously wanted it to happen. We kind of got the foreshadow that it was going to be a thing. Where'd that idea come from? And you're pretty brave for pulling it off, so talk about that.
So the bowl cut actually originated long before King Cougar started. I had a bowl cut when I was a kid, rocked it then, and just was like thinking about like, what if I cut my hair, what could I do to be like, just push the limits of like what we look like, and then see if I can actually have it as a haircut. And so I was gonna get a bowl cut whether or not like King Cougar happened when I cut my hair. And then King Cougar was 90s, and I was like, shoot, what if I got a bowl cut on stage? And then it was like the process of like 50-50 every day of like, no, I love my hair, I'm not cutting it. Okay, maybe I should get a bowl cut. No, why the heck would I do that? And then here we are.
Caleb gave you the opportunity to get a bowl cut as well, Ezra, but you've got this crazy dread stuff going on this year. Why'd you change your hair?
I changed my hair. I had dreads back in high school, and I just think they're awesome and they're cool and are a lot of fun to have. And so it's been a process of, I had to cut my dreads off for a bunch of different reasons. And then it's been a process over years of growing my hair out again to get dreads. And turns out that this past summer was finally the time I could get dreads again. So,
what does it take to get it in a dread?
Yeah, these are just fresh. I've had these for like almost 3 months. And you do wash your hair. Common misconception. I wash my hair every 3 days, thank you. There are not bugs living on my head. No, but you just take the section you want to dread and backcomb it and make it as messy and nappy as possible. I don't put anything in it, like there's no gross chemicals or what, it's just hair that's doing its own thing. If you stop caring for your hair, anyone can have dreads. So.
What was your guys' favorite part of this whole experience?
Man, my favorite part would have to be just getting the chance to host again and to give my very first haircut ever.
Yeah, my favorite part was getting a bowl cut easily. I'm not cutting it. It's continuing, so.
You're my best friend.
Yeah, no, it was so fun. And even when we plan and stuff, we laugh so much coming up with ideas and just like uncontrollable, so yeah.
Is there anything you guys would like to add that I missed that you talked about your experience or?
Thanks for letting us back as MCs again. We love it. Thanks for just the opportunity to pour into the community in this way. It's fun.
Seriously, it's a great time, and we just hope that we can liven it up a little bit, make it a great time for everybody, because we're just up there trying to have fun. So hope everyone had fun with us.